You were our hope in times of despair. We boldly declare you make us whole.
Sing with me, say,
you make us whole, oh God.
Emptiness.
Say you were out in times of despair. We boldly declare you make us whole. Say you make us. Despair.
In times of despair,
and I boldly
Yes, yes. He is the one who makes us whole. I'm hoping ukuthi ubucula kanye naleli culo, it is so relevant for such a time as this, ukuthi uyena uJesu whom osiphelelisayo even when we are in times of despair. Ekameni likaJesu. I hope you loved the show with Zanele Kamwendo. Just nje ngisacabanga with what she was saying, I'm reminded of a story that one guy was telling us about ukuthi you really really need to pay attention abantu yakubona. Like for instance, when you know ukuthi uyakubantu abashuqulayo and bakumemile, you need to put it in your heart ukuthi kuze bakuzwe funa ukuthi ugqoke njengabo. Yebo, not that mhlawumbe ukuthi usuke usulahla into eyiyona, but for them ukuze bakwazi ukwamukela the message that you are carrying, consider like ukuthi uthinte inhliziyo zabo before uthinte ini, ukathini baba uthinta ini isandla, uthinte inhliziyo before uthinte isandla. Yeah, egameni likaJesu. So this guy is telling us a story ukuthi he was invited to do a workshop like uzanele kadesho kuma businessman. So he's a white man, uyi poor like a poor man. Okay, so if he gets there ugqoka amabhuzu akhe, okay, ugqoke kahle ngaphezulu kodwa ugqoka amabhuzu lapha phansi, uthi yay, I've never had so much difficulty in connecting with people because I knew ukuthi ngangigqoke like a smart casual. Uthi ngathi mangikhuluma ngezi ngishayisa udonga up until ngihambe ngiye kulabantu laba, ngifike ngibabuze, ngibuzo yedwa ukuthi what is wrong, athi omunye yabona iy'cathulo zakho, hhayi angeke size sikwazi ukuza usagqoke lezi y'cathulo. Uthi wahamba nge-break, wahamba fike wahamba wathenga iy'cathulo, wababanjani wathenga iy'cathulo wagqoka njengabo. Uthi emva kwalokho is like there was a transformation eyenzeka ukuthi bakwazi ukuthi bamuze, and i-workshop yayisiba productive. So it's not about you being right ukuthi ngifuna ukwenza le nto engifuna ukuyenza. You see that ama-images usizanele kade ekhuluma ngawo ukuthi when people uthe it's an experienced, it's a visual image ukuthi when people see you really really they are going to make a conclusion, even noma uphethe into e-solid ebizobasiza, but they will make a conclusion ngokuthi ugqoke kanjani. So when people see you i-wrapping in a covering yakho abayibonayo ibatshelani. So is it telling them what you want them to know about you? So really really we need to consider this in danger, because as much as noma singayiphikisa kodwa ziqiniso egameni likaJesu. Nami ngiyakhumbula ukuthi ngelingilanga kwafuna ukuthi ngikhiphe isikhafe engangisiphethe ukuthi ngisifake ekhanda ukuze ngiphebeze negative perception engangiyizwa ukuthi people are not receiving me ngenxa yokuthi angishuqulile njengabo egameni likaJesu. So we are still waiting for the next guest ukuthi ibe available, and then sizobe sesiyake talking about depression and mental health egameni likaJesu. But we just want to acknowledge those who are with us. Ushishkel is watching, uMiningubo is also watching. We are sorry that we cut off abanye ababukeli bethu bebe kade bevela kwi-timeline edistebhekile. And we also have uSenzi Mandla, we have uMongesi Sikade uthi amen Jesus hallelujah, sinontokozo Makhanya, uDobe Mageba, hello mama over there, amen mama. Yes, image counts, it really really does count. And then we have J Coach Sobahle uthi amen. We have uMakhosi Smelane watching, and we also have a link there that we have posted which you can follow so that you can connect with uZanele Kamwendo. We have Ayanda Dlamini is also watching, we have uSphiwe Zondi watching, and Phumla Xaba is watching. So today, because it's a day before it pass over, we would like to know ukuthi what have you planned for it pass over. We know this time it's like we are going back to the beginning of the Passover where abantwana baka Israel, thank you Dogozo. And also we have la uDudu Msomi watching, we have uNonhlanhla Zamo watching, we have Shalom my son watching, and also uNonhlanhla is clapping hands, raising hands lapho, she say I'm worshiping with you Dr. Thabisile Msomi. And Sipho is on the SBS and Gimbalile. Please tell us, what are your plans tomorrow as we pass over? We know Uti, our pass over is going to be different. Some we have different emotions concerning Uti. The church will not be able to come together and worship the King of Kings. But it is what it is. So what plans are you having for tomorrow? Ekameliga Chase, we just want to say also to Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, or else if you would be interested to have church with us, which we will be having isidlo enkonzweni yasekuseni nasenkonzweni yasemini neyantambama, just so that we can break bread together. And also service namazwa 7 from different people, abanye from Mount Zion Carnation, abanye from outside. So please go and prepare yourself ukuthi ube newayini kanye nesinkwa ukuze ukwazi ukuthi uhlanganyele kanye nathi egameni lika Jesu. We believe ukuthi, as we know ukuthi we'll be celebrating Passover as families, you have already prepared that ukuthi uhlukanise nihlephule isinkwa together with your family egameni lika Jesu. So just share with us. And what I want to know, ngizwile nje omunye buza ukuthi makuphele lockdown yini nje othi nje mayiphela ngiyakoyenza. Can you share with us your thoughts makuphela nje i-lockdown yokwenzani? For me nje ngizohamba ngiye kwi-one of the restaurant ngiyodla khona and also heavy massage. Those are two things. Oh, another thing is to go to umpume ayongenza inzipho. Ngiyabona nje kuyakhalwa lana. Hallelujah. So those are a few things engizobe ngiyozenza, manicure, massage, and a good meal at a restaurant. Just share with me ukuthi yini ozobuyenza wena makuphele lockdown. We are looking forward to be free bakwethu egameni lika Jesus. Amen. So we are going to go to music manje. Udokotela will play for us one of the songs that he will choose for us, since it's a relaxed Thursday, as we are waiting for Umam Winnie, who will be talking to us about mental health and depression. We know that we are in a time where most people are worried about the future because we are in uncertain times. But how can you be stable and also make sure that your mind is healthy? Amen. Amen. And also, if you have a choice of a song that you want us to play for you, you can just rise and then we will play it for you.
ubone mina Zithi somhlekazi umuhle somhlekazi uyasabeka somhlekazi uyizulu somhlekazi uyasabeka
Yes, yes, sonjalo sithi uyizulu uyasabeka akekho ofana naye egameni lika Jesu. Keep those comments coming. I see ukuthi kukhona ababhalayo la ukuthi ikupha bazokwenza uma ngabe nje i-lockdown ithi nje down. Lapha ya uAyanda uthi yena ngizobuyela ejimini nami ngikhohliwe ukuthi ngisho ukuthi one of the things as much as izoyakodla but okunye funale ngihambe ngiyojima ezinye iy'mpahla ayisangilingani mhlampe nibonile ividiyo babade ipostile lapha ngibhizi ngikhuluba ngithi hey yo iy'mpahla zami ayisangilingani edansa laphana uyi-check-e lapha ku-Instagram ave edansa kamnandi. And also sizowafunda ngamanye ama-comments as we go on. Mama Winnie, we are not finding her for now. It's possible ukuthi sizophostpone ama ukuthi sigcina singamtholanga. She is, yes, a busy woman. So if kukuthi sigcina singamtholanga, we are going to transfer our appointment night to next week. Go any day next week, since tomorrow is Passover. And also during the weekend, siyazi ukuthi we would like to keep it down ingabe kuserious kakhulu egameni lika Jesu. Amen. So we are not finding her, so sicela ukuthi sithi waiver and then postpone it to next week egameni lika Jesu. We would like to see ama comments, Togozo, just to see ukuthi abazalwane ba comment abathini bazothi bona bazobe bekephi ngale lockdown. Let's see Tokozo wenu nawo lapho kwena. Okay, so abazalwane bathi bazobe be
Tokozo angilungisele lokhu ifoni ya Tokozo. Intokozo ifoni yakho ayidlali.
Okay, sibone-ke ku sorry guys for a delay. Izinto zethu la zibuye zenze ngendlela yazo, izinto zabantu abamnyama. Okay, so laphaya uAyanda uthi uzoye ejimini uthi lol mina mama ngizojoyina ngizojima and spoil myself ngishaya umoya. Yo, I've been indoors for long. Ngisinami me too. And then Nonhlanhla Zamola put me in and ngizoyakodla out and spoil myself and do manicure and pedicure. Me too. Then masesuphumla xaba lapha ukuthi after lockdown I need seafood platter. Then thereafter I need to get out more often. Need dinner with friends, movies, massage, doing my countdown already. Nami ngisho njalo Phumla ngithi nami hey I'm doing my countdown already but also I'm enjoying this time as much as it's very exhausting but I'm enjoying this time ngisendlini egameni lika Jesu. So please continue bangcwele ni comment ukuthi nizobe nenzani, what is it that you are looking forward to do once i lockdown yathi down. And also sicela nisichekele nalaphayana kuma watch parties would be corner and comment a corner. If you are commenting on a watch party, maybe let us ask you uti move to Sanimsomi for Tama Fortla so that we'll be able to see everything in one. But what I want to do now is just to answer some questions abantu abakade bengibuza wona, because privately I am a life coach. I know uti I haven't been advertising a lot of that kule platform. I am a life qualified life coach. And if you need assistance in terms of changing your life, as we were having Gail yesterday, you know what a life coach does. It gives you direction in impilweni yakho. You can also contact me so that I'll be able to help you navigate your life. So we have a question la. For those who do have questions, you can also send us a question so that we can answer them. Utilo obhale lana ke, by the way, amayama questions engiwatholayo ngiwathola kubantu abasuke bengekho necessary Christians. So ama questions amanye they are just about life in general. Lo uthi mama Msomi, be greeted in the wonderful name of Jesus. I am ngeke ngimbuze igama lakhe, but is a man from Newcastle I was listening to your powerful advice and I was touched. I am a divorced man since 2012 and I've been fasting and praying for ubambo lwami. Now God has just answered me and recently met someone whom I strongly believe that she is the one. But now there is a big challenge. She's about to leave SA for greener pastures, that is work. And she has done everything in terms of preparations. She has been praying and fasting for such a pastor and a husband exactly like me. Please pray for me, bless. Yeah. So this guy, he's divorced and then now he's been praying for a partner. Now she meets this partner, but the partner hlangana nayo exactly what she's been praying, he's been praying for. But now the partner nayo bigati kuleka. Ikulekela ama green pastures. And then ama green pastures, they are abroad, like overseas. And also ikulekela umyeni, nangu umyeni ulan. So unfortunately, it's not unfortunate, but life does bring you to a point where you have to make decisions like that. That is a tough one to make, but also not necessary for you, mister, but for her, usis. Ukuthi she needs to make a decision because it seems like izinto ayikhulekelile zifar apart. There are possibilities lana ukuthi kufanele kube khona oyedwa sacrificer into abakade ikhulekele. And the question is, are you willing in to sacrifice? Because there is an option yokuthi you go with her abroad. Because you've been praying for her and you love her and she is exactly what you've been praying for. So now could be you are willing to move Nang Baba La Payana over there. He's saying, yeah, that's serious. But it's a possibility. Are you willing to go with her? Because she's what you've been praying for. Or else on her side, it's a decision. She can be willing to make a decision. I'm taking one and then sacrifice another one. Because unfortunately, this decision is for her to make. You cannot manipulate her or whatever. And also, you need to put yourself in a place. So now, Mao decide that you're not going with her, you are okay to lose her. At the end of the day, uyena usanga decide to go to know I've been praying for a long time for umsebenzi okude. Then I'm going and pursuing my dreams. And then she goes and she leaves you. It means when a safanar kubege kukulege lomunye uzungkulunkula niyezon. But at the end of the day, it's just a question of what is it that is important. And then you make a decision. Kona lento baba agasfundisa yona of kwazi ukulisten to ukuthula ukuthi ukuthula kungakephi. So as you've prayed and then she came, you also need to pray and check ukuthi ukuthula kungakephi. And then I believe ukuthi uMoya Ngcwele will be able to advise ukuthi ufanele wenze njani. But on the other hand, you cannot make her choose you because usukhona. You need to allow her to choose for herself ukuthi choose and. Because if you influence her ukuthi choose wena, there may be a time where she says okokuqala ngachuza wena ngayeka into yami nomsebenzi wami. So she needs to come to a decision for herself wena khuleka ukuthi uNkulunkulu influence and also khuleka ukuthi uNkulunkulu akunikeze wisdom. That is as far as I can answer you. So unfortunately, decisions are not easy. Choices are not easy. But at the end of the day, as you pray, continue praying and then he will give you a clarity. And then we have someone else who says, hello, mama. Please, mama, ngibonise usisi engi tandana naye uya kuthanda. Ngiyamthanda serious. Ngiserious ngaye. Ngingaya ngisho kubo uma ezongipha uthando nenhlonipho, please mom. Okay, now khona into ilindile. Okay, akayishonga ukuthi uba igama lakhe. Khona into ilindile ukuthi usisi uyamthanda. Khona lento le kade ngikhuluma ngayo about unconditional love, the love that loves someone no matter. Okay, so this one, I believe whoever you are, your name you didn't tell me, this love that you are talking about here is so conditional that you are waiting for Rusi sikusukube khona into ayenza and then khona into ozoyenza. And if ku ukuthi uthando lunjalo, it tends to be very draining Because if kukuthi khona into wrong ayenzayo manje and then you will react kuloyo into wrong ayenzayo. So I guess clarify futhi again statement ukuthi kunosisi uyamthanda serious but you are waiting for her ukuthi akunikeze inhlonipho and nothando. Of which mina I'm just thinking ukuthi akakuthandi ngalendlela wena ufuna ngayo, akakuhloniphi ngalendlela ofuna ngayo. So akakalithidi leli bhethini eli-activate ukuthi wena uye ekhaya. My question uye komlobola uye ekhaya lakhe. My question for me, for you, from me is what if she doesn't love you ngendlela wena ofuna ukuthi akuthande ngayo ngalendlela ukuthi azathinta ibhathini ukuthi uye ekhaya lakubo. How are you going to make her ukuthi acciphize lelo button ngalendlela wena ufuna ngayo? So most of the time people, we as human being, we do this ukuthi you do this for me and then I will love you like this, you dance and you move like this and then mina ngizobe sengenza ukuthi. Most of the time when we give love like that, we are going to fail because that love is conditional. It's like if it's sunny I'm happy, if it's raining I'm gloomy. Yeah, well, but can we make ourselves grow in such a way we say, if it's sunny, I'm happy. If it's gloomy, I'm happy. If it's whatever, nothing touches my button your happiness. So it's just a decision that you need to make. Do you love her no matter what? Do you love her even if she doesn't love you ngalendlela or wena or picture shy? Do you love her ngoba uthi serious ngayo? Iba serious ke na uhambe ekhaya uhambe umlobola without expecting her ukuthi adance ngalendlela ukuthi achiphizele lo button, because it's not, it doesn't really work that way. I'm hoping ukuthi ngikuphendule kahle egameni lika Jesu. Omunye uthi mama ngiyakulalela mama, nginodade wethu owashada ngo-2014 kodwa akasekho kwakhe ngezinkinga eziningi ngosisi kanje kanye nomnyeni wakhe. Manje uyafuna ukubuyela kwakhe, manje asazi ukuthi uzobuyela kanjani ngoba sekuneminyaka emibili manje. Uma ngifonela umnyeni wakhe uthi akafuni nokukhuluma naye kanjalo nokuhlangana naye, labantu bobabili bashadile kodwa lento usisi wami uhlezi akhuluma ngomshado wakhe. Mama ngicela usisize kunzima, igama lami usibanibani. So ngeke ngize ngimushe igama lakhe. Okay, so this one is when somebody is standing on the outside looking at a situation yabantu abawu-2 abathandanayo and then basenkingeni now, and then usisi of course ngicabanga ukuthi uzama ukusiza usisi wakhe ukuthi abuyele emshadweni wakhe. Now the challenge lana, i-challenge hangi nango umama wini nyezo baba, i-challenge la ila ukuthi the time usise hamba, sometimes when people talk about
so by skirt kusana 30 minutes sana njani.
Okay, so sizobuyela ke ekuphenduleni umbuzo lo kade ngikhuluma nangawo, because nango mama wini now she's back, she has arrived. So sizosale sesikhuluma naye because we still have 30 minutes and we are going to be talking about mental health and depression. So sizozukuthi available in. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Baba.
Okay. So sizobuyela embuzweni wethu. When isimo esinjengalesi, sometimes this situation like this, they are complicated. There are so many dynamics that are involved. But umuntu mayesefuna kwenzeka intando yakhe, usuke efuna kwenzeka intando yakhe, akhohle ukuthi there are so many people involved and also abantu baneyintando zabo. Uwini ukhona? Uwini? Me? Uwini kancobo?
Noma asalise umsechaki.
Okay, sorry about that. So now there are so many dynamics. Mina into engayisho ukuthi usisi rather than ukuforce isimo akathi work on herself.
Okay. My earphones hang.
So buya embuzweni wethu, so buya sovisite futhi egameni lika Jesu. Mamwini.
Yes, hello.
My friend, unjani?
Ngiyaphila sweet, how are you?
Oh, I'm so blessed. God is good even in this time.
Oh, yes.
Thank you so much for joining us. I was a little bit worried. It's Aisha says of postponer, but no, I cannot pass this opportunity since also available.
Yeah, amen. Mm. I'm sorry. I was held up. I just finished my meeting now.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Just Sigwika Radio and also Sigwika TV, we are also on Eka Radio 82 is online. So just to bring a balaleli nababugeli ubatshela ukuthi uwini kangcongo cele why ebizwa kanjalo ngibonina ku Facebook ubizwa kanjalo ubani kahle hle.
Okay, can we proceed?
Yes, we can proceed. Yes.
Okay, let me just quickly greet all the viewers, the listeners, and everybody who is there, who is actually engaging or taking part on watching or listening to this program that is being run by the Tswanes.
Yes.
Winika Ngongo Tsele, it's none other than Winika Ngongo Tsele.
I love that. Yes.
Winika Ngongo Tsele was born in Port Shepstone at Ezinqoleni by the late Mr. Lakhe Ernest Ngongo and my mom who is still alive, Kamaxolo, Rosemary Umam Ngongo. I'm the third born at home, but let me just so that I just stick to the point.
Yes.
I won't speak to you exactly about my birth, but the thing is, I don't want to hide where I was raised up and grew up.
Yes.
Yes, and then I was born under the Free Methodist Church of Southern Africa.
Yes.
Yes, then I fellowshiped with Apostolic Church of Southern Africa under Umfundisi the late Mbabu Zulu and Umama Umfundisi Zulu. Then after that, when I was getting married, then I joined Holiness Union Church.
Yes, elakithi lelo. Mm-hmm.
Yes, so I'm serving under the leadership of Bishop Mambo and Zinhle Mkhize.
Okay, yes.
Yes, I am actively serving there.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm the child of God. That's what the viewers and listeners must know. I am the child of God.
Amen.
Not just by lip service, but I am serving God. Not only to entertain my leadership in church, but to actually grow spiritually and to be rooted spiritually.
Yes, yes.
So I am a true woman of God, not the woman of God, but that are questionable.
Yeah, yeah. And also, yes.
Yes, and then Winika Ngongo Tsele, you know, when we are studying now and again, you just feel like, I will be very much honest to you good people, you just feel like you just want to bring your maiden name because you just get lost along the way.
Okay.
So I will end up being Winika Tsele, of which I'm not Winika Tsele, I'm Winika Ngongo Tsele. I need to really to applaud my family of procreation.
Wow.
My family of orientation, I mean, which is the Ngongo.
Wow, yes.
And also the true gospel that they've actually given to me. Then, starting going forward, I'm a mental health practitioner.
Yes.
I'm also a lecturer at the University of KwaZulu-Natal. Dealing with mental health issues. I'm also a very much public speaking person.
Yes.
An inspirational person. I've mentored and I'm mentoring quite a number of people.
Yes.
Yes, I am a psychotherapist to those that they need my services. Maybe let me just end there. Okay, no. I am blessed with two girls and one boy.
Yes, yeah. I know that you are very radical. The first time I saw you, I was so amazed to see such a powerful woman. You also have a testimony of how God raised you from the sick bed, and I was so touched. Ukuthi kukhona abantu nje uNkulunkulu abakholwa ngalendlela la sekuthiwe nje yamukela isimo sakho kodwa uNkulunkulu avele enze miracle empilweni yakho. So we are so grateful for such women like you.
Yes, Tabi, it's the honest truth to such an extent that it has made me to write one of my books that is going to be published and launched anytime soon.
Congratulations.
I won't say when, but anytime soon. I've done with the book.
Yes.
Actually, that talks about my journey with Christ.
Yes.
Yes, as we have just alluded on it, you know, I'm one person who is having the testimony where people can actually see.
Yes.
Mina nje, even if umtengibona, ngiyilo muntu ekuthiwa, mhlawumbe ubaba wami wayengiqambe kahle mayithi ngushaka akashayeki. Because izimo or the situations, both unforeseen and uncertain circumstances, they've tried to hit hard on me.
Yeah.
But I am still standing and I am too stronger than yesterday.
Ah. I like that about
and
you.
And then what I've learned on the situation is that each and every situation that you come across with or that you face in life, it must give you a lesson than misery.
Yeah.
And you must also search what God, what is it exactly that God needed from you? What is it that God needed to teach you about? Because it's not about that yonke into esidlula kuyo noma yonke imlilo, all the fire, trials and tribulations that we come through or that we come across in life ukuthi alapho as demons or as amakhesis or whatever.
Yes.
But okunye uJehova usuke ekutrima down, okunye ekuprepareyela for future.
Yeah.
Ukuthi ukwazi ukufacea izimo, ukwazi wena manje uhambe usuyimentor phambi kwabantu. Uthi noma ngabe mhlawumbe ubuphakeme unepride, but wazi ukuthi ipride does not build but rather destroy.
Yes, yeah.
Because it is not godly.
So,
umina ukuhlala kwami ku wheelchair when I was declared as a person who was not going to walk again anymore.
Yes.
And then my feet started to take that shape, you know, of a person who was going to be wheelchair bound.
Yeah,
You know, iinyawo zomuntu osuke ngeke sahamba ziyaphenduka zibe incane zibe into ongayazi ngoba vele seyithatha isimo se-permanent wheelchair.
Yes.
But, you know, washo ukuthi imkhuleko yabazali. I remember my mom. I'm very much proud of my mother, I must say. Unomathemba, ukaXolo Ngcongo. Ukuthi the gospel abasifundisa yona kithi emndenini wakithi yiyo le eyangisukumisa ku-wheelchair. Because ngavele ngagijima nayo in my life. Ngavele ngahamba nayo to such an extent that ngase ngiplanta as a seed also to my children.
Yes.
Because ngalesikhathi sekuthiwe ngeke ngisahamba, I remember when I spoke nonsense. I always say it was nonsense that I spoke at that time. When the team of health professionals they surrounded me, then I was told, formally told and been declared to say, there are no chances that she will ever walk again.
Yeah.
So, and then I strongly said to them, I look at them, all of them around that boardroom and on that table, while I was on a wheelchair and my family was there being counseled of how to take care of me going forward.
Yes.
But you know what? I strongly said to them, my God will raise me from the wheelchair.
Yeah.
Not you, but my God.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then when I was saying that, I remember that I just busted into tears because I was now actually doing like Hezekiel, who was facing back on the wall, facing the wall, to say, God, I've been serving you. Kumbulo kuhle ngikwenzile. Then ngakhala ngasengithe enhlizweni yami, kodwa Jehova bekomele ungisuse kule wheelchair ukuze kwazeke ukuthi wena noma abantu basemhlabeni odokotela abakhulu ama-psychiatrists, ama-psychologists, ama-mental health practitioners, ama-neurologists, ama-physicians, ama-spine surgeons eseshilo ukuthi no, there are no tenses, but whether you are not the respecter of any situation or any person.
Amen. Amen.
And then it just happened that way. And then my younger son, Eyetu, the only son that I had at that time, was 7 years old.
Yes.
On the bedroom of my younger daughter, where I used to rest, because I was being taken in and out of a wheelchair using that plank or that whatever to the mode of transport.
Yes.
At times I remember when I was walking on my house, I will just you know push myself, or else in the hand so when you're handing it, I know what is good life, I know what is bad life.
Yeah.
So ngihambe ngesisu ngikline ngikoroba ngilele ngesisu because ngiyithanda into eningi.
Yeah.
But the day ngizosukuma, I remember my son uAyethu at the age of 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
So God, if he can help him to be the pastor one day or the prophet of the word of God.
Amen.
That day he just came in, walked in into my into that bedroom, and then he said, "Mommy, you don't belong to this chair. Just take courage and walk."
Sure.
At the age of 7 years, mind you. And then when he said, "Take courage and walk," I my flesh, my mind, my brain told me that, you know what, he doesn't know what I'm going through.
Yeah.
So that is why it's easy for him and he's still young. And then, but he persisted. He consistently saying, "Mom, you don't belong to this place. That's a... take courage, stand up and walk. If you are afraid of walking, that maybe you are going to fall." And mind you, my operation was very new because they did stenotomy.
Yeah.
So it was very new and isabega. So, and if ngale so sikhathi ngathi ngiyasukuma ngiyiwe, ayikwanga bekusekupheli lento. So but my son kept on saying, okay, he first asked me the question, "Mom, where is God that you always teach us about? Remember, we pray every morning, we pray each and every evening before we sleep. You always tell us about the miracles that God do to people, or else that God is able to do. Then why can't you believe in those powers, those supernatural powers?" And then I again, this one, he is young, he doesn't know what he's saying. And then he eventually said to me, "Mom, stand up and walk. I will hold you." Then I said, "No way, you can't hold me. You know, a medical hazard will take place here." And then he said, "No, why are you refusing? Today I'm denying your God."
Yeah.
"Mom, where is your faith? At times we need to have faith, even if kubizu pila kwethu." So I just take that courage. I said, "It's fine, come and help me then." And then he just came to a bed where I was sleeping on, and then he just held my hand. And then while he was holding my hands, I just started sweating from head to toe. And then he said, "Do not sweat, do not fear. Your God is holding you, not me." At the age of 7 years, my and then yes, we started. I just stood up for the first time. For the first time.
Wow.
I stood up for the first time. Then I sweat again. I was becoming dizzy or whatever. And then when I was standing up for the very first time, yes, I managed to stood up, and then we took a first step. We took a second step. We took a third step. And then I just became like, I felt that easiness.
Yeah.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
And then I felt that easiness as if really somebody was holding me, not my son. But my son was used as a tool.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, as a God's tool. And then I walked. Guess what? When I was telling those health professionals in that institution, when they were declaring that I was not going to walk again, I told them that I will walk. I will stand up for the first time on a certain day and the date and this month. Guess what? When I looked at the time, when I was standing up, it was already 9 a.m.
Yeah.
On the exact day of the 25th day, I said to God, and we were on agreement with the Holy Spirit to say, I will stand up regardless of who said what.
Wow.
Then I stood up. So what I'm trying to say, uNkulunkulu uyabheka ukuthi umthemba kangakanani engaxutshwe nalutho.
Yeah.
You don't have to have plan B.
Mm-hmm.
You just need to surrender and to immerse yourself in the blood of Jesus.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, God. And the power of words that you've declared. Even when, even in daughter, Nisikulum is like he was an angel sent by God. Esikulum is like you forgot, but the words were still like lingering and then standing for you.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
Yes. And from that day, I never looked back.
Wow, that's amazing.
From there, why in season? But that was the power of the Holy Spirit. I cannot say ngihambe ngithandazela abantu babone. But my church, they know ukuthi kwavela abantu bengabone emehlweni bengakaze babone. Athi umoya ingcwele, go and lay hands on them.
Mm-hmm.
Then they will see.
Amen. Amen.
Uyabona ukuthi lapho umoya ingcwele ube sengazuthi ukwenza a stupid person because what if lo muntu engaboni?
Sure.
Abantu bazothi ubuwenzani?
Mm-hmm.
Uyabona. Then that is why kumele ubuyele kuyena uSimakade ukuthi must I do this. Unfortunately, when the Holy Spirit comes, ufika ungalindele athi enza lokhu, but kuyafuneka ukuthi ubheke kuye uthi Jehova, mengabe lokhu it does not come to pass or kungenzeki, kothi kwizwi lakho.
Yeah.
So uNkulunkulu engakushiya limele izwi lakhe because abantu bebebona bangabona.
Amen.
Bephila bagulayo.
Amen.
UNkulunkulu, he just put me through that journey so that ngizokwazi ukuthi ngibe nale faith ukuthi when you lay hands, a clean hands, and in good standing with God, izinto ziyenzeka. Be in good standing with God.
Amen. Amen. Yes, Mom Winnie, because of time now. You are doing mental health. Now, we are in this time, COVID-19, in lockdown.
Yes.
And also, even nasemabandleni, people are depressed, but we can't talk about it because it seems like something that cannot be talked about.
Yes.
How do we get to a place where we are healthy mentally, even for those people who have maybe just crossed the line by a bit depression? Yes.
Thank you for that again, Tabi. I must say to the viewers and listeners that mental health aspect of people during this crucial time and critical time of COVID-19, it has been affected greatly.
Yes.
It has been affected greatly to such an extent that affected even I'm a breadwinner. And can you imagine mak affecteka I breadwinner at home? Abantu abazinomizofunda noma ngeke ifinde. And what is happening on the mental health aspect of these people?
Yeah.
On the mental health aspect of the country at large.
Yes.
In an African context and also globally. Abantu manje bacabanga ukuthi should I get infected, the next phase for me is to die. And then it has also psychologically affected the economy of the country.
Yeah.
Kunabantu abanye njengamanje kule lockdown abazophelelwa imisebenzi.
Yeah.
But their main worry is how are they going to survive going forward? So that alone, in mental health aspect yabo iya challengeka kakhulu.
Yes.
So beside uchallengeka kwe mental health aspect yabo, lento le manje ino negative impact socially ngenxa yokuthi manje abantu bethu sibabona siyabona ngendlela nje okoqala bathenga ngayo eitolo ukudla.
Yeah.
Abanye sebethenga ingathi ngeke liphinde libe khona ikusasa. But konke lokhu kwenziwa yini? Kwenziwa indlela le COVID-19 efike ngayo.
Yes.
So what I can say ukuthi le mental health aspects ibashayile i COVID-19 ibashayile abantu. Ishaye ngisho amakholwa. Ukuthi manje asecabanga ukuthi umhlaba usuyabhubha. Cha, umhlaba awubhubhi. Isifo nje esifikile kodwa futhi esizodlula.
Yes.
Ngifuna mina uqinisa iviewer nomlaleli ekhaya ukuthi yes, we understand ama challenges enibhekene nawo. Ngenxa yalento, and we understand i pain yonke.
Yeah.
enibhekene nayo with regards to this.
Mm-hmm.
Kodwa akufuneki ukuthi usale usuwenza izinto that are uncalled for.
Yeah.
Ngoba abanye bagcina sebenza izinto that are uncalled for.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and these things are like ngirefer where umuntu engasakwazi ukucabanga completely.
Yes.
Umuntu esenza izinto with anger ukuthi vele mangishona. Okokuqala nje i-COVID-19 i-disrupte even ama families.
Mhm.
Ngoba khona abantu abangakwazi ebebengakwazi ukuhlala nabantu noma abayeni babo noma amakhosikazi abo.
Mhm.
Lento iyodwa yavele manje ya-eda usizi phezu kosizi.
Mhm.
Siyabuka indlela ekwenzeka ngayo njengamanje even nakuma domestic problems.
Yes.
Le disease ibe ne opportunity ya affecta yokuthi affect destroy ama lungs like severely.
Mhm.
That has led to ama severe respiratory disease.
Yes.
Ngenxa ukuthi it is highly contagious.
Mhm.
Yabe isiba nale sudden impact and negative to the economy as I said earlier on.
Mm-hmm.
Not only kubantu but ku government and nakuma public health system, because nabafuna ukutestwa abakwazi ukutestwa ngenxa ye high numbers of volume of people that need to be tested and those that have presented with signs.
Yeah.
Ama communities nje okoqala a affectekile emqondweni ukuthi umuntu uyasaba nokuphuma ukuthi mangiphuma anginayo i protective gear.
Mm.
And then ngizoyithola kanjani mask? I don't even have money. Ayabiza manje nalama mask.
Ayabiza, yes. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Usiyabona even ama health professional.
Mm-hmm.
Nawo ayawashodela.
Mhm.
Banovalo abantu ukuthi mengabe efika one of the members yala ekhaya kade to such an extent that khona abantu esebegeza abantu emagateini manje.
Sure.
Mengabe kade ephumile abamlento bathathe i host pipe bamsinge ngayi gateini. Angithi ukuaffecteka lokho psychologically.
Oh God, yes, yes.
I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Abantu manje sebegeza ama fruits ngamanzi ashisayo bafake zonke izinto ongayicabanga ezinye ezizogcina nazo seziyingozi.
Mm, mm,
mm. Ukuaffecteka.
Mm-hmm.
I-COVID-19 ke ayiaffecti abaphuwa
kuphela. Yeah.
Ayiaffecti. Mm-hmm. Futhi abangakholwa, iaffecta everyone across the board.
Yes.
And njengoba ke lento le COVID-19 impose a negative stressors to people.
Mm-hmm.
Especially nakulaba ba self employed.
Yeah.
Small business companies.
Mm-hmm.
That are now unable to pay their monthly debit bills.
Mm.
Not only bills, but they can't provide food for their families.
Mm-hmm.
I pressure now. Government is having a pressure.
Mm-hmm.
That is being put on government ukuthi support us but by this.
Mm-hmm.
But siyazi ukuthi South Africa it's a developing country.
Yeah.
Bazoyithathapha imali yokusupporta all these people who need to be supported.
Yes.
So psychological well-being of the millions of lives of people, they've been affected.
Mm-hmm.
And sizwile World Health Organization esho ukuthi lento iba affecte kanjani. Mhlamba ke ngimela umbuzo umbuzo.
Yes, now how do we swim upstream? I mean downstream. How do we relieve the pressure now? Okay, this thing is big and it's invisible. It cannot be controlled unless ukuthi kutholakala cure, and then for us doing these things that we need to do, say social distancing and also like lockdown. But now with these things suyibalile, how do as an individual relieve myself of this impact?
It's simple but not very simple.
Yeah.
First of all, it's to comply and adhere to a lockdown rule.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And do exactly as we are being instructed to do.
Mm-hmm.
It will save us.
Yeah.
If people can keep themselves indoors.
Mm-hmm.
And safe, and if abantu bengasusa le negative mental health aspect yokuthi bona this thing it's for ama races athile.
Mhm. Mhm.
Ngoba iyona oqala leyo ezobulala.
Yeah.
Ukuthi mina ngeke izing affect iaffect abathile.
Yeah.
Lama anxieties as we say ngesinawo ama panic attacks and then sizogcina sino depression.
Mhm.
Ukuthi try to calm down.
Mhm.
Try njengoba usendlini mm-hmm. play with your children,
mm-hmm.
Be a joyful family.
Yes.
Iban nama social activities enwenzayo nidlalele.
Mhm.
Nithini nigijime nje just in the yard.
Mhm.
But just try to keep yourself busy with something.
Mhm.
So that you avoid le fear of the unknown.
Yeah.
And ngifuna ukuthi kubantu into ezosibulala more than COVID-19 fear.
Mhm. Yeah.
Ile panic attack esinayo. Lendo, it's like HIV and AIDS. Mm-hmm. I think before you were diagnosed, you didn't know.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And you were continuing to live your daily normal life.
Uphila kahle nje, uhleka, ujabula, uhaga abantu, yes.
Uyabona. So now, what has changed? Ngoba nakho usudiagnosiwe. Because ukudiagnosewa kwakho, kufanele kukwenze kube i-eye-opener ukuthi ish, I didn't know. Mm. But now, at least I know.
Yeah.
Then let me live right.
Yeah.
Let me comply mm-hmm. with the daily healthy lifestyle.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Abantu more than anything, abazame ukuthi the way they react, abanga ithathele phezulu, futhi abanga exaggerate.
Mm-hmm.
And futhi abanga stigmatize noma ba discriminate those that are already affected.
Yes.
Or infected.
Mm-hmm.
Ngoba leyo nto izokhoza laba esebe infected ukuthi noma bebezosinda kodwa the immune system yabo, because it has already been affected,
mm-hmm.
then they fear even more down.
Yeah.
They rather support them. Yes,
amen.
They cannot be with them, like bahlale ndawonye,
mm-hmm.
but let them support them,
mm-hmm.
psychologically and emotionally.
Yeah.
And bangaba discriminate. Because lento at the end of the day, to each and every family, exotwina lento izobanga into ekuthiwa post-traumatic stress disorder.
Yes.
Where, for instance, if maybe one breadwinner or member of the family
mm-hmm.
has died of this COVID-19,
mm-hmm.
abantu umndeni ngeke uze ukhohlwe ukuthi during this COVID-19, we lost our breadwinner.
Mm.
And that is why today sibhekene nalobunzima esibhekene nabo.
Yeah.
Abantu bese beqala ukukhetha uNkulunkulu. Ukuthi why God did you allow?
Mhm. Mm-hmm.
UJehova bekufanele aalawe bananga alawe bani.
Mhm. Yeah.
Uyabona.
Yeah.
So it's about us ukuthi indlela esithatha ngayo i psychological mind state yethu.
Yes.
Ibe practical and realistic.
Mhm. Yeah.
And stick to the lockdown rules. I know in lockdown kwamina as a person isinganele njengamanje. I had enough of it.
All of us are feeling like this. Yeah.
I'm already having enough. Mm-hmm. But in order not to infect more people,
mm-hmm.
especially if you are not yet tested,
yeah.
you rather remain indoors. Self isolate yourself.
Yeah.
Social distance yourself.
Yeah.
Just keep this basic personal hygiene. Mathwa sanitize. Uma ingekho sanitizer, enye into futhi ebulala abantu psychologically, mamthwane, ukuthi abantu uthi umuntu ngoba nakho anginayo imali yesanitizer, angitha khona amanzi nensipho. Geza ngamanzi nensipho ugezisise. Uwash izingubo obuzigqokile.
Yes.
Bese uyazitshela ukuthi ngizophila.
Amen.
Uyabona?
Yeah.
Zitshela ukuthi I am still going to live long.
Yes.
This COVID-19 izodlula.
Mm-hmm.
Njengoba nezinye izifo zafika zadlula, naso lesi sizodlula. But the thing is, the question is, when what do you do to contribute positively during this lockdown?
Yes.
Is to keep yourself indoors.
Yes.
And play safe.
Yes. Mm. Yes. Thank you so much, Mam Wendy. Because of time, we've gone a little bit over time. I would like to invite you again because, there's so much that I feel you can share. Nabazalwane, and also we know that you travel abroad. Just give us a perspective. What do you see, Mohamba Mazwe? What do you deal with? Iziphi izinto njengamanje uqoxa nje. It opens our eyes thina esilele endlini ukuthi khona into enje izenzeke eminyango esingayiboni thina. So we would like to invite you again, but we just want to say thank you for your time. And also umuntu ofuna ukukuthinta nofuna hlambda usizo lwakhe in terms of mental health and psycho is saying nje le ini psychotherapy angakuthola kanjani?
I do have a practice ebele medical center.
Yes.
Ngiyatholakala kuyona. Uyabhukha i-appointment. I-appointment ibhukhwa on this number. Let me just give you the number where you actually book an appointment.
Okay.
And then
please wait. Your call has been placed on hold. Please wait. Your call has been placed on hold. Please wait. Your call has
been... Hello?
Yes, Mama. Yes.
Hello?
Yes. Yes, Ma.
Yes. Okay. Sorry for that. The appointment is booked on this number.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to give you the number.
Yes.
It's 071.
566.
42.
42.
37.
37. Can you say it again?
0071 567 567.
Okay.
And the other one is 060 399 161.
Okay.
060 399 161.
Yes.
Ngiyacela kodwa abantu irrelevant.
Okay.
Umuntu abe straight to the point. You are booker. You are seeking advice, and then into eganjalo. You will get my PA there on 071, and then also on the other number.
Okay.
And then they will communicate with you, and then yes.
Okay, thank you so much, Mama. You're such a strong woman. You inspire us. We are proud of you just to know there are these fearless women that exist in our world.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you so much. I'm humbled. May the good God bless your viewers, bless your listeners, and let us just remain standing.
Amen.
In knowing God and under trying to understand God better.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye, Ma.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
So sizweleke babukeli nabalaleli, that was Winnie Kangcongo Cele, such a confident woman who is impacting the world, traveling all over with the gospel of Jesus Christ, and also tackling the issues that deal with mental health and everything that deals with mental health. So if you think you need her, so nazi number ikhona sizoyi-attacha futhi on your timeline. And we mina ke ngiyintokazi Nkosikazi Kaswane Msomi, Ntokazi yakaZondi waZondi Msomi uyangibuka ubabala. Sengithi bye bye. Ama questions ethu sobuye sifunde la question, phinde ngi-answerishe futhi. If you do have questions that you want to ask, please DM me, like ngisendele question on Messenger, and we shall surely tackle it here on this platform and then help other people who might have the same question as you. But me, having said that, I'm checking out and I'm saying I love you so much. See you tomorrow, as we say, remembering the death and the resurrection of our Jesus Christ. Amen.
Shadow of the Lord.